Hey guys, I'm LB, and let's read Hippocratic Corpus. Men ought to know that from nothing else but the brain come joys, delights, laughter, and sports, and sorrows, griefs, despondency, and lamentations. And by this, and in a special manner, we acquire wisdom and knowledge, and see and hear, and know what are foul and what are fair, and what are bad and what are good, what are sweet and what unsavory. Some we discriminate by habit, and some we perceive by their utility. But this we distinguish objects of relish and disrelish according to the seasons, and the same things do not always please us. And by the same organ we become mad and delirious, and fears and terrors assail us, some by night, some by day, and dreams and untimely wanderings, and cares that are not suitable, and ignorance of present circumstances, destitute and unskillfulness. What is this word right here? Desuetude. I don't know. I do not know. All I know is that I have not seen it before. The human brain is a machine for coming to conclusions. If it cannot come to conclusions, it is rusty. When we hear of a man too clever to believe, we are hearing of something having almost the character of a contradiction in terms. It is like hearing of a nail that was too good to hold down a carpet, or a bolt that was too strong to keep a door shut. Man can hardly be defined after the fashion of Carlyle as an animal who makes tools. Ants and beavers and many other animals make tools, in the sense that they make an apparatus. Man can be defined as an animal that makes dogmas. As he piles doctrine on doctrine and conclusion on conclusion in the formation of some tremendous scheme of philosophy and religion, he is, in the only legitimate sense of which the expression is capable, becoming more and more human. When he drops one doctrine after another in a refined skepticism, when he declines to tie himself to a system, when he says that he has outgrown definitions, when he says that he disbelieves in finality, when, in his own imagination, he sits as God, holding no form of creed but contemplating all, then he is, by that very process, sinking slowly backwards into the vagueness of the vagrant animals and the unconsciousness of the grass. Trees have no dogmas. Turnips are singularly broad-minded. Interesting. The human brain is a product of the development of matter, and at the same time is an instrument for the cognition of this matter. Gradually, it adjusts itself to its function, tries to overcome its limitations, creates ever new scientific methods, imagines ever more complex and exact instruments, checks its work again and yet again, step by step penetrates into previously unknown depths, charges our conception of matter without, though, ever breaking away from this basis of all that exists. Neuroscience. Psychological history. Volunteer suffered a blood clot during infancy which resulted in a left hemisphere stroke. Expected result. In normal adults, the left hemisphere is used for language and other cognitive functions. Extensive damage to this part of the brain usually results in severe cognitive deficiencies. Observed result. Volunteer is now 17 years old and displays only very subtle cognitive deficiency. MRIs indicate little to no activity in the left hemisphere, suggesting its usual functions have been taken on by neuron sets in the right. Volunteer's age at the time of the stroke may have helped the brain to adapt. Yeah, there's still so much we do not know about the brain. New stuff added. Alright. Let us continue exploring this massive, massive area. Have I been there yet? What the? There's a star on that thing! Ha! Okay, well, I'll look at that in a moment. It looked like a blue laser receiver would allow me to get the star somehow. Just look at this view. There may be a lot that I don't understand, but I know this is beautiful. Oh, is it? Interesting. Alright, I think it's time to get to a puzzle in a moment here. Where did we come in at? Here, right? Yeah. Alright, first, I want to look at the center area here. So, if we find a way to get a laser here, it'll blow us up high enough to get the star? I have been running this gauntlet for generations, trying to find the right answers. I am fast coming to the conclusion that there are none. I actually would not put it past this game to have impossible puzzles. Let's go here first. Slightly elevated sigil. Hey, that's interesting. Nope. Oh well, it was worth a shot. Got the high walls here to prevent that. Okay, you are coming with me. Let's see what the purpose of this would be. Why would we want to do this? Definitely can't see the tower from here. Okay, I don't know yet. Do that, now it can sustain itself, and then we just do this. Okay, that wasn't hard. I don't know. But there is a blue laser here, should we ever figure out what to do with it. Okay, is this a puzzle? This does not appear to be a puzzle, though there may be a recording here. Everything else is in this direction. Let's go to this one over here. Me, myself, and our two jammers. If we see a blue laser... So we got a recording thing here. Hey, that's something. So... okay. Let's set this up. Put this here. Actually, right here, please. We'll record standing on the button and doing that. And I guess we just wait, right? Because our future self is gonna be doing its thing, right? I think this is enough time. So, let's replay. And we're gonna go through here, and do that. Oh, but that's a problem. That is a problem indeed. Ah! I left the jammer in there. That is a... well, actually... wait a minute. We can still recover this. Hey, wait a minute, what? Hey, that's not actually helpful. Now I am definitely trapped. Okay... I need to think about what to do here. Well, the music stopped, that's freaky. I do not know how to do this one. Wait, I hear a robot. Oh wait, no, that was just... that's just me running into the fuel, duh. Oh, that one's not even... I feel like an idiot now. I thought that was... okay, okay... that at least makes a bit more sense. I can do that. Hang on. So how about we start recording, we open the door for ourselves, and then we jam that long enough for ourselves to get over there, then we... Oops. Come on. Can I not? I don't think I can. I think we want to jam that once we get over there. Right, okay. Let's try doing it this way. So we stand on this to let ourselves through. Then we want to disable that. Give ourselves time to go put our jammer on that. And then we want to do this. And I think that's it. Try it. Do that. And I think that's it. Yeah! That was it. Awesome! I thought I wasn't gonna be able to do that puzzle. Okay, how about we just continue in a counterclockwise fashion? The four chambers of flying. That turns the fan on. Interesting. Same thing here. Where did that go? Where did that go? Oh, right there. That was funny, did you see that? So I'm on this side, and I click take, and it moves me to it, instead of just letting me take it, whereas here I could just take it from that distance, no problem, see? Take. But, because I'm on the other side of a fizzler, it moves me across the fizzler before letting me take it. Cool. Let's get this first. Oh, there's messages here. I'm getting better at this. I figured this one out in minutes. But where is it all leading? I work, I rest, I work. But to what end? We are born and die and live again. This eternal cycle must be the nature of existence. Life is merely repeated suffering. An eternal cycle is another name for a prison, but you must understand the cycle before you can break it, for it is possible to escape and yet remain a prisoner, or to break the cycle by breaking yourself. This was the fate of the ghost that haunts this world. Where is this guy? Also, yeah, we can detach the fans. good to know. Where would the receiver be for said laser? Right there, huh? But that's a no-can-do at this moment in time. How about I just do that? And I wanna see where this thing goes. I'll just leave that there, and I think I should still be able to get back without trapping myself. So that's the end. Yeah, okay, so it sends me over here, that's good. Is that the only one? Why? How would I even reach anything with this? I don't know, I'll have to figure it out next episode. So, as always, if you hit the sound of my voice, leave a dislike, it's up to you, and I will see you all in the next episode. Goodbye!